Well, hello there. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to set a future membership date in PHP. So let's get started. I will start with my PHP code by opening the PHP tag and closing it. The next thing I will do, I will type a string that says that your membership is valid until. And I will also include a line break at the end by adding the HTML br tag. And as always, close the line with adding a semicolon. Now in a variable, I will define the validity of the membership. You will define it here, how many months or years it will be valid. So I will add a variable called validity. And in single quotes, I will type, let's say, 1 month. If you want, here you will define the exact time of the validity of the membership. You can type here 3 months, for example, 5 months, 1 year, 2 days, and similar. Now we will define the date when the membership ends. So to do that, I will define a new variable called date, and we will use a new date time object to create a new date. If we just leave it like this, the new date time will give us the today's date, but we want a future date. To define a future membership date, we will use what are called the relative date strings in PHP. You will define them in a textual form, like the example now. So we say last day of this month plus, and then we concatenate the validity, which we have defined it here. So what this gives us is it will get the last day of the current month and will add to it the period of time we have defined in the validity variable. So in this date we have the last day of this current month, which is 30th of June, plus 1 month, which will be the ending of July 2020. You must make sure that you type this correctly in this section. Even a small error, like if we type in here or any other text, won't work, will give us an error. I will show you that later. In this example, I won't be using any databases to store this information, but in a real example, you would store this in a database when you create a membership account. Now let's say this comes from the database and the user is logging in, and you need to check if the user account is still valid. Then to do that, we will compare it to the today's date. So we will create a new variable called today date, and we create it, as I told you before, we're just creating a new date time object. And now we'd like to compare it, the date of the membership with a today's date. To do that, we type if, then we type date, which is this date here. If that is greater or equal to today date, then let's say in the real example, you would log in the user, but I will just type echo. I will make this bold, the date, by adding the BHTML tag, and then I will concatenate the date and format it to the day, month in textual form and year format. You can format it in another format if you want by just playing with these characters here. And then finally we need to add a closing bold deck. And we can also just add another line of text just to let the user know that the membership is still valid. So we'll add a HTML tag and type. If the date or the membership date is smaller than the today's date, it means that the membership has expired. So we'll do that in the else section of the if statement. We'll type echo. And now we can go ahead and test it. I have an error here that just it needs to be format, not formatty. So I will delete the ending E there. And we can test it. Let's move this to the left. The name of the project folder is future date, so I need to remember that. Make sure you have the Apache server running and type localhost here. I'm using XAMPP, so we'll type localhost future date for the folder name, and the file name is set future membership date.php. Well, we have an error here, so let's see what we got. Oh, I made the change here, but I didn't save the file, so let's save it. Let's refresh it here. We would need to add a BR break, online break after this line, so I can go down and echo and always save, then refresh it. As you can see, your membership is valid until, well, we did it twice, so I will delete this part. Remember to save it, and your membership is valid until 31st of July 2020, and it says your membership is still valid. Now let's say I want to go back to a already passed date to get that your membership has expired. I can add a minus here. Instead of plus, it will go back to the date. And let's save it and refresh it. So it says that your membership has expired. We want to check the date when membership has expired. We can copy this line and add it here as well and save it. So it says that your membership is valid until 31st of May 2020. So that your membership has expired. This part needs to be typed correctly following the strict syntax. Let's say if we type here last day in this month, you make that mistake and save it, you will get a fatal error because the PHP does not recognize it. It must be written in the exact manner. The last day of this month minus the validity here, and it gives us 31st of May 2020. If you want to learn more about this, the relative string dates in PHP, you can check this documentation link. I will provide you with the link in the description below. It gives you all many other examples you can use to use the relative string dates. You have the examples here, like for example, first day of January this year, last day of December this year. I will write another example how to use this. Now I have added another example, so I've added two break lines just to see the example below what's printed over here, this part. And I want to find the third Tuesday of the next month. So to do that, I will create a third Tuesday variable. I will create a new datetime object, and as a parameter I will type this string third Tuesday of the next month. We want to find the third Tuesday of July 2020, and here we just print it in bold third Tuesday, and we do it in the date month year format, and we close the bold tag. And now I have saved this file. If I refresh it, here we have it. The third Tuesday of the next month is 21st of July 2020, and to verify that I can go here and find July and This is the first Tuesday, second and the third Tuesday, so 21st of July 2020. Okay guys, so this example can be useful in many cases whenever you want to find a future date that you want to save, like future date for membership, or like that second example, to find a specific day in the future month or future year. There are other ways to do this, but using relative string days gives us a very intuitive way to do this. Just remember to write the exact syntax and don't make any errors there. Hopefully this will be very useful in your next PHP project. This is another PHP in Visual Studio Code tutorial from me. Hope you liked it. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you have any idea for another tutorial that you guys want me to explain it to you, just write them in the comments as well. I hope this was useful. Don't forget to follow us and subscribe to our channel. If you want to learn more about PHP and Visual Studio Code, I have a playlist that you can access by clicking the card above. I hope you guys learned something from this tutorial, and with you guys, see you next time. Thank you for watching and bye.